Do your NavMesh agents have jittery movement when you set a new destination? In this video, we'll see how to transform that jittery movement into buttery smooth movement. Hey, Chris here from LlamAcademy, here to help you. Ooh, me? Yes, you! Make your game dev dream become reality by helping you make better AI. I'm gonna be honest, this didn't used to be a problem for me, and I've used a lot of NavMesh agents. But since Unity 6, I've started to see this weird jitter on NavMesh agent movement when we set a destination. This even happens with very few NavMesh agents in the scene. For a bit of context on how NavMesh agents work, when we call NavMeshAgent.setDestination, Unity does a lot of stuff for us. For example, it picks a location on the NavMesh that's close to the point that you provided, because the point you provide is not guaranteed to be on a NavMesh. It kicks off a job, so it doesn't run on the main thread, to calculate how does this agent go from its current position to that target point. However, because it's a job and not running on the main thread, this happens asynchronously, potentially over multiple frames. When it does take more than one frame or it's not calculated in the exact same frame, the NavMesh agent path pending property returns true, saying, hey, I'm trying to figure out how to get to that point. And what we see with Unity 6, 6.1, and 6.2 beta is that when that path pending is true, the agent stops moving, giving us this jitter. So the agent stops, then usually one or two frames later, it's like, okay, I know where to go now, and it starts moving again. And then if you set the destination again, we get this weird start-stop behavior.
But Chris, how do we set the destination without calling setDestination?
That's really the critical question, right? To do that, we can use the NavMesh calculate path API, which accepts the source position, the target position, a NavMesh query filter, and a path. It then returns true or false if it can calculate a path from that source to that target position and populates the NavMesh path with the path. Then we just call NavMesh agent set path to the path that the NavMesh calculate path calculated. That means that we're never landing in this path pending state and our NavMesh agents can move buttery smooth. But this is more than one line of code and we have to do this anywhere that we want to set a destination to avoid this problem. That's where we can use a feature from C# called the extension methods, which effectively allows us to write our own custom functions and make that appear to be part of the NavMesh agent class. So we can make one called NavMesh agent extensions and make a public static bool set destination immediate. And the way extension methods work is we say for the first parameter, this and the type that we want it to work on, NavMesh agent, gives a name, agent, and then we can provide any other standard parameters that we want to take in, like the target location. Then we can just put in all of that code, make a path, get our query filter, check if NavMesh calculate path returns true, giving it all those arguments. And if we can set the path, we can return true. If not, we can return false. However, remember earlier, I said that we don't always pick a location that's on the NavMesh. So a lot of the times, if you do this, just drop and replace, it's not going to work because a lot of the time you don't pick a location that's directly on the NavMesh. So we can add in an optional float to our method signature here saying, hey, what's the position leniency that we want to provide? I don't know what the default one is for NavMesh agents. So we can set it by default 0. And if our position leniency is not 0, we can do a NavMesh sample position to find the nearest position on the NavMesh based on that position leniency as the radius. And if we can't even sample position, then we know it's not going to calculate a path and we can early abort returning false. Then this becomes a little bit less of a drop-in replacement because we want to provide a position leniency. I found that doing something like the radius plus the stopping distance plus the height may be a little bit over generous, but it works. Especially if you have some verticality, adding the height really helps. And like I was saying earlier, this appears to be new behavior in Unity 6. In my no longer available Lava Survival mobile game, I had over 100 NavMesh agents active following the player, and I never saw this problem before, even on mid-range mobile devices. So it really feels like there's some change that happened within Unity that started causing this path-pending thing to happen and make the NavMesh agents stop. In this Dino Attack micro game that is just about to launch, make sure you're subscribed so you're notified as soon as this gets launched, because the full project code is available to you on GitHub for free, and the full game is playable on itch for free as well. Over the coming months, I'm gonna be doing a lot of videos covering how I did all these different aspects of this game, like this video right now. And if you wanna learn more about how to do all this type of stuff, make sure you're subscribed. Now, if you're making your game dev dream become a reality and you wanna show your support for this channel, there's a few ways you can do that. You can get yourself some LlamAcademy merch right here on YouTube. You can take my 24 plus hour real-time strategy game course that just came out, where you'll learn how to make your very own RTS game. You can also become a YouTube member or Patreon supporter. Your recurring contribution there helps tremendously. You'll get access to a private members exclusive Discord, and you'll get your name in every GitHub repository that comes out as long as you're a supporter. You'll also get your name up here at the end of every video, as well as a shout out starting at the awesome tier, like Ivan, Iffy Obelis, Jason Hansen, Sneddon, Trey Briggs, Will B, Mustafa, Nick5454, and Pixel Wizards. There's also all of these great supporters as well. Thank you all for your support, and I'll see you on the next video.